lots of different songs and things for you guys to hear today. And nobody's paying attention to me now because all of their kids are out here. Okay, last little thing. Free to take pictures, take all the videos you want. Please just be mindful of your neighbors. Don't like stand up and like get in their way, because I don't know about you, at least my mom would like throw down if somebody was walking her when she's taking a picture. So feel encouraged to take pictures, all that stuff, but just make sure you're doing it in a respectful way. All good? Awesome. Okay, you guys ready? Feel good? Okay, Miss Denise is gonna get us all lined up perfectly, and then we're gonna get started.
A time for rejoicing. A time for
keeping promises.
Keeping promises?
Not exactly where I was going with that.
But it's true. From the beginning of time, God has always kept his promises. Just look at Adam and Eve.
Who, us?
When God made Adam and Eve, he wanted to be close to his creation forever.
Right. God made man to be close to him. But then Adam and Eve made a really bad choice.
He made me do it. The snake.
But you still made a choice.
As I was saying, they made a choice to sin against God, and it broke the relationship between God and man forever.
But God had a plan to keep his promise and bring us back together again. For real, we set this whole thing up and all these people are watching.
Exactly. Christmas is the time to remember all the great things God has done.
There's no better time than the Christmas than to sing about it.
Come let us
great things. In fact, he's given us everything we need.
In the Bible, God's people sometimes thought they knew best.
Never heard that before.
They stopped trusting God and took matters into their own hands.
Ooh, like in 1 Samuel 9, when the Israelites decided they wanted a king. Instead of relying on God, they chose a man named...
Saul's name, and you're welcome. Always wanted to see my name in lights. Israelites, that is.
Saul was a handsome young man who stood head and shoulders above the rest.
It's all right, man. My mom has problems with dandruff, too.
Well, I never.
Liar.
But Saul turned out to be a bad choice, so God appointed David as king.
David was a king who loved God, but even David didn't lead perfectly.
Israel wanted a king, but we were still missing something. The king we needed couldn't come from earth like me. He had to come from heaven. And many years in a quiet night in my hometown, God provided the true king we needed.
Thank you. were ready to explode with excitement. The Son of God was about to be born.
But it sure was beautiful. All of heaven was rejoiced because the promised king had arrived.
I remember it like it was yesterday.
When they arrived, they found Mary and Joseph and the baby lying in a manger.
Shh, he's sleeping.
We receive the gift.
Shh. How dare you?
The shepherds heard the news from the angels. Then they went to the glorified and praising God for all they had seen and heard.
It's really him, the one we have been waiting on. We have to tell everyone,
praise God!
But Mary treasured up all these things, pondering them in her heart.
Behold, the Son of God has come. His name shall be called Emmanuel, God with us.
Thank you.
when we were trapped by our sins, God promised to rescue us.
When we longed for a king, God promised the King of Kings.
And when the world needed saving, God promised to save you.
When we tried to go our own way, God promised the Good Shepherd.
When we needed a miracle,
God promised a Messiah.
And when the world was filled with darkness, God promised the light.
Christmas, something that God's promises have always been true.
And the truth has never been clearer than the day our Savior was born.
Christmas and all year long. Thank you.